When it comes to air travel, us frequent flyers know the drill pretty well. We put up our tray tables, turn off our electronic devices, and stow our carry-on under the seat in front of us. But have you ever stopped and wondered why? We'll explain some of the reasons you should really listen to your flight attendant and reveal some things you should never do on an airplane. When flying the skies with the richest, you should always press the red subscribe button and turn on your notifications. Take off. You might feel the most nervous when you're thousands of feet up in the air, but the most dangerous parts of flying are actually takeoff and landing. When your flight attendant tells you to put your tray table up and make sure your carry-on is stowed away, you definitely want to listen. You should never disregard these instructions, and you should never close the window shade if you're sitting in the window seat. Why? If something goes wrong during takeoff, you are going to want to make a hasty exit from the plane, and that's going to be hard to do if you're bumping into your tray table and tripping on your bag. Leaving the window open means that if firefighters or rescue workers are looking for you, they'll be able to see where you are from outside the plane. Being located as soon as possible can be invaluable when your life is in danger and every second is precious. If you do end up leaving the plane in an emergency situation, leave your luggage behind as instructed. When Captain Chesley Sullenberger landed U.S. Airways Flight 1549 in the Hudson River, he was amused to note that all the cargo inside the plane was salvageable, while those that tried to rescue their own items ended up having to toss them. Drink the water. Due to the lack of humidity in the air, flying can make you feel rather dehydrated. While drinking plenty of fluids is a good idea, you definitely want to make sure that you opt for bottled. If you've ever noticed that you never see flight attendants drinking the coffee or tea on a plane, that's because they know that the tap water on an airplane is pretty disgusting. In 2004, the Environmental Protection Agency took water samples from various aircrafts and discovered that 12.6% of them contained coliform, which is a type of bacteria also found in fecal matter. Out of the 158 planes in the study, they also found two of them with water that tested positive for E. coli. Both coliform and E. coli are bad enough, but scientists say that they can also indicate the presence of other unsavory germs that simply weren't tested for. According to Business Insider, 1 in 8 planes fails to meet the EPA regulation for water safety, and we just don't like those odds. Not only do you want to stick to bottled water on a plane, but get your drink without ice, since it's made with tap water. Not to mention the fact that flight attendants confess that the ice trays and scoops are very rarely washed. Emergency landing. If you fail to heed our advice and end up with an upset stomach from drinking tap water on the plane, hopefully your container of poopery made it through security. If you make a mess in an airplane bathroom, the flight attendants aren't going to simply clean it up for you. Not only is that not in their job descriptions, but it's simply impractical while the plane is in the air. Making a mess in the bathroom means that area is going to be out of commission for the rest of the flight, much to the dismay of your fellow passengers. One man flying to Dubai via British Airways had such stomach issues that the stench emanating from the bathroom caused the plane to make an emergency landing. 30 minutes into a 7-hour flight, the pilots decided that they could not continue due to the odor and made the decision to cancel the entire flight. The airline claimed that the decision was made for the comfort and safety of those on board, and the flight was rescheduled for the following day. Tray tables. We mentioned earlier that you want to leave your tray table up during takeoff and landing, but you might be best off just leaving it up for the whole flight because you never want to eat off that table. We know it seems convenient and even has little divots for your beverage, but unless you plan on scouring it with sanitizing wipes, you are going to want to steer clear. These tables are generally not cleaned between flights, and your fellow passengers use them for everything from eating to changing diapers. When testing surfaces of planes for germs, the tray tables are the hottest spot for all sorts of unsavory bacteria. During one test, scientists found 2,155 colony-forming units of bacteria per square inch of tray table. To put that in perspective, the flush button in the bathroom only had about 265 CFUs, and the seat buckle had 230 CFUs. The seat pocket filled with magazines is another area that you'll definitely want to avoid. Researchers have found that the antibiotic-resistant bacteria MRSA likes to lurk in these pockets, and the material lets it live for an entire week. Using electronics. We all sigh unhappily when the flight attendant asks us to turn off all of our electronics, but have you ever stopped to wonder why it's important? After all, there has never actually been a case of a plane plummeting out of the sky because someone was checking their Facebook during takeoff. If your plane isn't on airplane mode, it can actually cause a lot of interference that the pilots have to deal with. In general, it's not that bad, but the more people neglect to put their phone on airplane mode, the worse it becomes. The sound of 50 phones all looking for a radio tower at once can be supremely annoying to pilots, and we would much rather they're able to concentrate on landing the plane safely. When it comes to laptops, the real concern is that these items could become extremely dangerous in case of turbulence or a rough landing or takeoff. We're sure you can imagine the damage an unsecured laptop could do if it were to start bouncing around the cabin of the plane. Also, while there is no confirmed evidence, there have been numerous cases of safety issues that are thought to have been caused by personal electronic devices. It's time for our in-flight trivia question. We mentioned earlier that takeoff is a particularly dangerous travel time, so it's a time you want to stay awake and alert. Besides a possible plane disaster, what is a possible painful consequence of snoozing during takeoff? We'll tell you when we land. Open the emergency exit. We feel like we shouldn't have to tell you to not open the emergency exit if it's not an actual emergency, but a shocking number of people have done so. One woman claims that she didn't do it on purpose and merely confused the door emblazoned with the words emergency exit with the bathroom. Luckily, this was just on the runway and not while the plane was in the sky. Another man was so impatient to get off the plane that he decided to open the emergency exit and slide down the emergency slide out onto the tarmac. Needless to say, this did not go over well with the airline or his fellow passengers, who were then forced to wait hours for the slide to be deflated before they could leave. There was an incident on a Delta Airlines flight from Chicago and Beijing where one passenger was strangely intent on opening the emergency door mid-flight and had to be subdued by crew members. He ended up being arrested after landing, but thankfully it would have been impossible for him to actually open the door during a flight due to the cabin pressure. So we are sorry to have to tell you this, but unless it's an emergency and the plane has landed, just stay away from the emergency door. Oxygen mask. We all know that the flight attendants instruct you to put on your own oxygen mask before assisting others, but what is the worst that could happen if you didn't? After all, you may be traveling with your small children who are helpless without you, and surely it makes sense to help them first. If those oxygen masks drop, you had better put yours on, and fast, and yes, that means before helping your kids into theirs. You see, without oxygen, you have only moments before hypoxia starts to set in. Hypoxia will make you feel sluggish and affect your vision, making assisting others or putting your own mask more difficult. You may also feel strangely euphoric and forget what you are doing entirely. When enough time passes, you will fall unconscious and pass away if you don't get any oxygen. Securing oxygen masks is a quick process, but if you don't take care of your own first, by the time you're ready to don your own, it will likely be too late for you. Stay seated. Flying on a plane can be a great time to relax and catch up on some reading, but before you settle in for a few hours, you might want to make sure you remember to get up and stretch every so often. Being so high up increases your risk of developing deep vein thrombosis, a blood clot that can form in your legs. It's also known as economy class syndrome because of the small amount of leg room offered in economy class. If these clots make their way into your lungs, they can develop into a potentially fatal pulmonary embolism. In your tiny seat, your body struggles to pump blood from your legs back to your heart. But when you get up and walk, your calf muscles help pump the blood back up to your heart. In addition to standing up and moving around every once in a while, avoid wearing tight clothing that might further limit your circulation. You want to get up and move around at least once per hour, but if for some reason you can't, try to lift up your legs and twist them in your seat just to keep the blood moving. Germs. Avoiding your tray table and the seat pocket are great ways of avoiding germs, but while stretching your legs, you might also be accumulating germs if you don't wear your shoes. It might sound strange to some, but flight attendants say that many people shed their shoes on airplanes, which isn't the best idea since the floors are very rarely cleaned. Travelers have been known to throw up or spill other bodily fluids on the floors of planes, and that's definitely not something we would want on our bare feet. To further help keep germs away from you, resist the urge to turn off your vent if you start to get chilly. Those fans should be set to medium or high in order to help blow away any airborne germs that may threaten to invade your personal space. If the vent is making you feel cold, consider donning a jacket before you wrap yourself up in the complimentary blanket. Those things barely ever get washed, and who knows what sort of germs the last passenger was carrying. Flight attendants have seen people sneeze into them or use them to wrap their feet up in. Window seat. We understand the appeal of a window seat. You get to stare out the window without seeming like you're peeping at your neighbor, and you don't have to worry about the flight attendant banging your elbow with a snack cart. But there are hidden dangers lurking around the plane window that just may have you choosing the aisle seat. It can be tempting to rest your head against the wall of the plane for a quick snooze, but we hate to tell you that the passengers before you likely had that same great idea. Laying your head where a stranger was drooling just a few hours ago is a great way to end up sick. If you were savvy enough to bring some antibacterial wipes, be sure to hit this area of the plane as well. If you do end up by the window, be sure to slather on some sunscreen. While the glass blocks out UVB rays, dangerous UVA rays can still pass through and cause damage to your body. At cruising altitude, you're about 6 miles closer to the sun than normal, so that's definitely something you want to keep in mind, especially if you're sensitive to sunlight. Did you figure out the pitfall to pre-flight snoozing? Falling asleep before takeoff will make it harder for you to equalize the pressure in your ears as the plane reaches cruising altitude. You could wake up with one splitting headache if you sleep before your ears pop. If you've taken to the skies before, what is the grossest thing you have seen a fellow passenger do on a flight? Tell us your sky-high horror story in the comment section. Thanks for flying with The Richest, and don't forget to like our video before we land. Be sure to catch us on the next flight.